ocean acidification occurs when atmospheric CO2 dissolves into the ocean. That CO2 undergoes a series of chemical changes. Two important net results that occur from that: the pH of the water goes down, so it's becoming more acidic, and then the ion bicarbonate is going down, and that's one of the ions that organisms that produce shells, calcium carbonate shells, need in order to produce their shells. So ocean acidification is going to have a direct impact on the natural resources that we like to harvest from the Puget Sound. But it also is going to affect the food web, the base of the food web. The increase in CO2, which is utilized by phytoplankton in order to photosynthesize, they're going to be impacted as well. And we don't know if they're going to be impacted favorably or detrimentally. But any time that you have a climate stressor that affects natural resources and the base of the food web, that's cause for concern and it's cause for further study. So anything we can do locally to minimize our impact to the water is going to be big. The second thing, though, is this is a global problem. Atmospheric CO2 concentrations are rising. And so what I tell people, how do you combat that? The only answer I have is education. If I can give a talk to 30 people, those 30 people can go out and talk to 30 more people. Those 30 more people can continue that exponential rise in information. And so if we can continue to educate people, maybe eventually then we can start to make inroads on a global basis as well.